Thanks for messing around. Vampire Survivors BESWEC 114 starts now. Time for some She-Moon Eeta. Man Forest? This time I will not get random and select lost and found painting. Spinach is on the map, clover is on the map, spellbinder is not helpful, candelabrador is. Hey, I get out of bounds correctly now. Wings, bonus box. What else? Empty tome, of course. Of course, of course. And maybe probably actually a trapdoor. Alright, it should be a pretty easy win. Oh, does duplicator affect it? I really need to check this ahead of time. But no, trapdoor. Want to level up as fast as possible. And guess what a trapdoor is very good for? That's right, swear clear Ichi. Gotta get that Santa water. Into Lobora. Oh, it does have duplicator effect. Oh well. Ah, nothing's getting frozen. Really, both of them at once. Well, Tronos Box is pretty rare. Wait, doesn't it have to evolve first? Ah, dang. Nope. That's for later. Nope, I need the empty tome. Man, a duplicator again and again. Okay, it's at least strong enough now that it's hidden all around me, so I can stay still for a bit. Dude, can take down that boss. There you are, empty tome. How about we max you out so that this can happen? Well, not that it could evolve, but still. I should have waited. Just in case. It's like an endless spear of glassy doom. Except it's not yet. It has to evolve to be the Glass Fadango. Hey, no. Well, now it's endless. So that's nice. And Labrador, here we go. Out that empty tome and just walk up north. Get silver ring, make it nice and big. Ah, very nice at this level of speed. It's just endless. We looping into each other. Probably just do this and become invincible too. Yeah. Skeleton wave's pretty good one to just farm a bit so I can level up. Bye bye, skeletons. You are too good for this world. Hey, how girl are you? Wait, I need to evolve first. And also, that was dangerous because I have Tronus Box almost maxed. Yep. Even the Mud Men are having problems getting in, and you know it's probably going to be a win. Without even spinach, too. Nice. Ooh, that's really off-center. Oh, I forgot to get the Hollow Heart. Well, whatever. I can just get it on the back end. Let's make sure you're not taking out any of my treasure boxes. now go to Hollow Heart first, and then I can go to Spinach. I'll just take him out with incidental damage. I can maybe run the whole map because I have wings, so let's use that to our advantage. Hey, Minotaur Wave. And I'm going to be agile enough to avoid things and get stuck on terrain a bunch, and then glide around it after. Hollow Heart, I beat for you. Hollow Heart, as empty as my soul. Ooh, are you stuck? You're stuck for now. Uh-oh, I'm not stuck though. Oh, this is basically the mowdown. Fire and ice, it's fire and ice. No evolution this time. Gotta be that 10-minute drop from the mantis. Pretty close to getting the first spinach. Hey, boom. Let's get the pickup range up so I can get my remaining levels faster. Right. And that basically makes a full map. Ah, Spellbinder actually wouldn't have been terrible to keep that going, but that's what Silver Ring is going to be for. Alright, level spam because of all that. Ooh, I took a lot of damage. I'm actually so fast I'm going to run into things, huh? Well, not after a bit of spinach. It's Metaglio, right? I don't want that, but I'm going to be running right by it anyway. She maybe... Oh, of course, Stalker shows up. She may be pretty strong, but she's not. Take down cursed enemies strong. Get away from me. Yeah, I've said it before, but I was not expecting Stalker, of all things, to be the one that was just making waves like this. Why did that not drop something? Oh, that was lucky. Alright. Celestial Vold. Evolved. Where did I get Grim Fadango from? That's the video game, isn't it? What? Why did it go away? Oh, either way, clear its sail. Time to get Pomerola. Oh, it's so much safer, as long as I don't run into Atlanteans. Gotta keep my eye on the ball so Crab Battle doesn't get me either. Your Arcana Bat. Whoa. Wait, no you weren't. Where's our combat? Is that our combat? There it is. Yeah, probably won't need a wake, but I've lost so many runs as it is, I don't want to take the risk. Alright, on good track to grab Pomerola and Clover, and that'll boost up the chance of things freezing. Oh, right, I need out of... No, I don't need out of bounds. I have out of bounds. Explode when frozen, that means anything that happens like this just wipes them all out. And there goes the Atlantean. Huh, didn't get close enough. Oh, really? Really, Drowner? Come on. That all you got? It was very easy. This is actually easier than a regular run, which is strange. And again, Conchetta's was as well. Odd that, eh? And yet I had to restart because I grabbed Lost and found Pain on accident because I hit random instead of get. Go figure. So I just want to say thanks for watching. Hope you're having a good day. Should be a bit till some more Vampire Survivors DLC comes out, so I'll have plenty of time for Unicorn Overlord streams. Finish that off. Then, well, who knows what I'll be doing after that. Well, getting a gigantic backlog of this, for one thing. But I definitely do not want to spend any time on Vampire Survivors, when instead, I could play Iudan Chronicles. Also, apparently, I got the dates wrong, and Iudan comes out after the 16 DLC. I thought it came out on the 16. Wait, maybe it does, and that's Early Access. No, there is Early Access, which I'm going to get. Like, probably right after I finish out this runs. Alright, time to go grab Pomerola. You know, like I wanted to. For the reason I came down here. Would have helped make those chickens better. Just a lot of time going to grab it when I was right next to it. Yay, health recovery. Yeah, even the mummy mudman wave is going down with no trouble. You know, it's a strong, easy win. Not what I was expecting. Well, I guess I really aren't expecting anything outside of character I haven't played all that often. Since this, the ones I have played on stream are like all my... Well, not stream, but on recording. Don't need that chest. Why am I going for that chest? Are basically the more I've played of her than ever before. What am I saying videos? This won't be all of the second video I have done with her. And heck, it's the first and second time I... Well, I guess not with Bat Robert, since I did on Bat Country to unlock him. Was that out? Dang. Did he unlock the Paco Batelier, or... Did you unlock him with the Paco Batelier? A chance to freeze. That means more chance of destruction without a bound. Bye-bye, Batwave. And it's Clover's time to shine. Alrighty, alrighty. And can I just sit still and let it fly out? Probably, but I'm sure I'm going to get a Starburst on this random event. Skeleton Swarm. No. Oh, that's a random event. This is probably more damage, but most things... Oh, it's the little flying skeletons, not the ones you annihilate in a single hit. Wow, you're durable if you're surviving all this. Yeah, probably because you're not getting frozen, so out of bounds is doing less. Wow. Even the flowers. Oh, hey, Celestial Vulgin. Look at it go. And it's only going to get stronger, too. Oh, yeah, you get benefit of slash, hey? Oh, that means this is even less threatening. Alrighty, what to do? Well, at least it's not 19 minutes like it usually is. Which is strange, but hey. Wait. I think I've changed how I want to do the third waves. Instead of like doing three characters with three, or one character three times in a row with three different builds, or three item restrictions, I'm instead, oh hey candy box, gonna do three characters to a video with, well, the same item restrictions. But that way it's not gonna be all set up on one. It makes the BESWEC look weirder. The Check-off look weirder. Thanks for sticking around. Hope you're having some fun, both in real life and watching this video. I know I'm not the most entertaining voice to listen to. Probably because I still don't have a microphone and this is a headset, but that will change eventually. Sometime this month. Maybe even before I Uden. I just, you know, rent's due first of the month. You gotta get your priorities and your bills in order first. How long the rising tide's gonna be. Like, Echoes of the Fallen was just one pretty long dungeon. It wasn't that long. Heck, I could just go look that up right now, but I think it was only like 3 hours. Rising Tide's probably gonna be, I don't know, maybe 10 at most. And then that, I'm thinking, might be a bit too. Overestimating? Generous? Generous, that makes sense. I know Yudan's gonna take forever in a day. If only it was released in the year that didn't have Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, maybe we would have had a chance. But that is the reality we live in. There's no way that's not winning all the game awards and stuff. Will it be my favorite game of the year? Who knows? I'm the guy who put Immortals of Avium as my favorite game of the year. So clearly my opinion can't be trusted. Maybe I should do a playthrough of that. You know, I saw the developers do a playthrough and it was only getting like a couple hundred views and that just, that just made me seem so sad. I really liked that game. Damn, look at her just tear through the big bat waves at the end with no trouble. I can just walk through. Most of them aren't going to survive. If they do survive, they get frozen, so I'm perfectly healthy. Over level 100. Not six digits, but a solo weapon on hurry. Pretty dang good. Heck, technically better than Queen Sigma, because she didn't lose a revival here. You heard it here, folks. She-Moon Eeta is the toppest of the top tiers. Oh, I still have 30 seconds to fill. And Simpsons jokes. How dare you bribe me with malt? I mean, is the rat milk better than malt? I don't know how important vitamin R is. Oh, thank you, Death.